Hey folks, it's Hunter Dalton with SPS back in the building. We're at the home of the Muskegon Big Reds at the Muskegon Basketball Classic. Got Ben Harden and Muskegon faces off right now. It's going to be some noise in the back. I got Mr. Jared Pittman right here holding it down. Representing, man. How you
doing? Yes, sir. I'm good, man. Thank you for this opportunity, man. I appreciate it.
No, man. You come highly recommended. I've been hearing great things about your work you're doing with your podcast. You went to Kalamazoo College. I got some stories that you shared about Kalamazoo College and Western Michigan. And, man, after my own heart, that's my alma mater being a graduate with. But just tell us who Jared Pittman is and why we need to get to know you a little bit more.
Man. Jared Pittman is becoming a brand. He's becoming a brand.
I like that.
LLC called Homefield, HOMEFLD. It's going to be a combination of a whole bunch of things. Right now, I'm starting off the podcast. I'm going to get into some YouTube and get to some motivational speaking engagements, some leadership seminars and whatnot. And it's my legacy for my children when I'm done with life.
Yeah,
that's really what it is.
Let me tell you something, man. I meet people all the time, and they talk about what they want to do, and I never want to take anybody off their path. I consider myself not a dream killer, but a dream clarifier. But it's something about you and the passion you have and what we talked about offline that you have really owned this. How is that moving in you like that, man?
Honestly, man, I think it's just me being quiet and letting God guide my footsteps. I believe he's given me the gift to inspire and motivate, and I've exemplified that on numerous occasions, and I'm just going ahead and tap into it because it's about time I do that.
Yeah, it's about time. Talk about what it's like dealing with your generation. Normally, I talk about the generation of athletes. You know, you have a sports background. You talk about going into sports management. But how difficult is it sometimes to impact your peers?
It depends on who you really want to get to. Because the individuals that I'm trying to get to are the ones that's going to listen. But for the ones that are difficult to get to, you know, it's just really a sense of versatility and understanding people, right, and being a listener and being attentive to what they're saying and then responding in a sense of not for your own satisfaction or a response, but to understand where they're coming from and then give them something to relate to in that response.
Yeah. I don't know if this is a generational thing. You got so many young people, at least from my generation beyond, who's all about going to college and getting a good job and working somewhere for 25, 30 years, getting a gold watch and that shit. What you're saying is you're talking about starting off with an entrepreneurial mindset.
Yeah, absolutely.
Where does that motivation come from?
Man, just because, if I'm going to be honest, man, I've considered myself as a boss type person. You know, I understand that you got to follow before you lead, right? And I've been doing that for quite a while. And I just decided to take my own life into my own hands and make things happen for myself.
I love that, man. I love that. What would you say to a young person that may be feeling what you're feeling but may not have the right kind of people around them? They have negativity around them. They have people telling what they're not going to do. What would you say to them to get finished by?
Honestly, man, it's you versus you. You know, that's the type of mentality that I've embodied.
It's you dropping the quarterbacks out here, baby.
It's me versus me, having a no-flex mentality, meaning that whatever is going on in life, I know I'm going to figure it out and get on the other side. And then just knowing that everything that you want in life is on the other side of hard. So I got that from Monty Williams when he told his team that after game three loss in the finals.
Sure.
And when I heard that, it really resonated with me. Right.
Yeah.
And I understood that it takes work to get wherever you gotta go. And that's what I tend to put it in.
Yeah, we got the world of cloud going on right here. We're going to get to this game.
Yes, sir.
How you
want to
shout out before we let you go?
Man, this is my family. You know, I appreciate y'all for your support. Everybody that does, tap in to home field. You can find me on Instagram at PITT.XX, on Twitter at PITTXX _. You can follow all my content at Home Field, the podcast, or on Home Field Media on YouTube.
What we're going to do, man, we're going to make sure that information is available to everyone. But we're going to make sure you and I follow up. Maybe we have you on as a guest for the SPS.
Yes, sir. Let's do it. Let's get money.
Got Jared Pittman right here talking about good talk, baby.
Yes, sir,
over at the Muskegon Showcase. We'll see you guys next time. Peace.